Hey Dr. Anne, can I still exfoliate when on retinoids? How often can I use my AHAs with my tretinoin? Do my chemical exfoliants go in the same routine as my retinol? I can't count how many versions of this question I have had in the last year, and I get that. Retinoids on their own can be pretty intimidating, and no one wants to aggravate the side effects by overdoing the acids. But how often do you need to exfoliate when on retinoids? Is tretinoin an exfoliant? Which exfoliant goes best with your retinol, and which skin type should use which product? Let's talk. If you're new here, welcome. I'm Dr. Anne, a physician passionate about skincare and well aging. What can happen if you pair retinoids with chemical exfoliants? Well, in the best case, nothing will happen and you'll live happily ever after with soft and glowing skin. Every skin is different. What might happen though, if you are less fortunate, is that the irritation potential from the chemical exfoliant and the irritation potential from your retinoid will combine or even maximize each other, leaving you with tight, red, and flaking skin that is sensitive even to water. Not always instantly, that's the tricky thing here. Sometimes the irritation takes a few weeks to develop, so you feel you're fine, and then one morning your face goes crazy. The problem here is that this is often not a short-lived thing that goes away once you stop what you're doing, but that this can lead to an impaired skin barrier that takes a long time to heal, with inflammation, irritation, and reaction to other things that were previously fine in the process. That obviously depends on a lot of different factors that we will discuss in detail later, but the main takeaway is it could happen eventually, and if it does, it is not fun. I won't go into detail on the damaged skin barrier and how to heal it now. I already have videos on that topic that I will link, but over-exfoliation is one of the more common reasons for it to happen. Is tretinoin an exfoliant? Now, if I say over-exfoliation, does that mean that tretinoin or the other retinoids are exfoliants? No. But they do have exfoliating properties that resemble those of alpha hydroxy acids. Quick recap, chemical exfoliants work at the skin's surface where they dissolve the glue that holds the dead skin cells together so they shed quicker, getting rid of skin texture and revealing the newer, brighter skin underneath. Retinoids, on the other hand, speed up the skin turnover process, meaning the skin cells are replaced quicker, so again, you'll get newer, smoother skin on the surface. The end result is similar, the mechanism is different, and combined, it can be too much. Do you always need to use both? So, when retinoids have a similar effect on the skin as chemical exfoliants, can't you just stick with one of them? Of course you can. Not everyone needs or tolerates a retinoid in their routine, and those that already use some kind of retinol, especially one of the stronger ones, might find it to be all they need to reach their skin goals. Don't feel pushed to use a retinoid and an exfoliant just because some Pinterest skincare routine features both. But for some, and that includes myself, even tretinoin alone will not be enough, so they will want to find a way to have both in their routine. What is the best way to pair retinol and exfoliation? That is entirely possible, just take it slow and always listen to your skin. You might remember from my video on how to introduce Retin-A with minimal irritation that I recommend introducing retinoids very slowly, starting with once or twice a week and slowly building up to the point where you can use it consistently without any problems at your desired frequency, which for me is every other night. Then, and only then, is the time when I would start reintroducing exfoliants, again at a lower strength or reduced frequency, or maybe as a different form of application, for example as salicylic acid cleanser as opposed to a salicylic acid leave-on product. When doing that, look for early warning signs that it is too much for your skin, like products that were previously fine starting to sting or flaky skin starting to appear around your mouth. And if that happens, take a step back to let your skin recover. Also take into consideration other changes you are experiencing, like switching your moisturizer or the seasons changing from hot and humid to cold and dry, and always think about other potential ways you might be exfoliating, like using a cloth to take off your cleanser as opposed to just rinsing it with water. I would also suggest using them at different times in your routine. Either use the exfoliants on your retinoid off days, the thing TikTok calls skin cycling, or use your exfoliant in the mornings and your retinoid at night. For me personally, the following works best. Tretinoin every other night year-round and the salicylic acid 2 to 3 times a week in the mornings depending on the season. The only time I use AHAs is in late summer, early autumn, when I appreciate their extra help in reducing the hyperpigmentation that reappears when I spend time outdoors in the sun. Which chemical exfoliant works best for which skin issue? Now, depending on your skin type and skin issue, here are some suggestions that I think might work for you, assuming you want or need to use a retinoid. Remember, not everyone needs to. You can have a perfectly fine routine without them. If your skin is very sensitive, rosacea or eczema prone, I wouldn't risk using both, but stick to one or the other. But if you insist, try using polyhydroxy acids that are among the gentlest exfoliants available. If your skin is more on the sensitive side and you feel you need a chemical exfoliant to help with hyperpigmentation or inflammation, polyhydroxy acids or mandelic acid might be right for you. Acne-prone skin that still gets congestion and inflamed acne lesions should try pairing their retinoid with salicylic acid, either as a wash-off in the form of a cleanser or as a leave-on product if that is tolerated. And if hyperpigmentation or premature aging are what you want to address and your skin is pretty sturdy, then an AHA like lactic or glycolic acid can be used, with glycolic being the strongest one with the highest risk of potential irritation. Although retinoids are not exfoliants, they can, when paired with exfoliants, lead to irritated skin and a damaged skin barrier. As retinoids have in part similar effects to exfoliants, it might be that you don't need to use both in your routine. Listen to your skin here. If you do feel you need them, start slowly, opt for more gentle chemical exfoliants, or try wash-off formulas rather than leave-on products. Try to use them at different times in your routine, for example in the mornings or on your off nights, and don't use them daily. If there's anything you'd like to add, please do so in the comments below. I will link to more videos you might find interesting in the screen, and add links to my Instagram, blog, and Patreon account in the description box. See you soon. Bye!